Hey everybody, my name's Tyler Watson, your Las Vegas and Henderson Realtor. This is Tour Time with Tyler and welcome to Regency at Summerlin. Let's check out this model. So, I am ready to move in. How cool is this? And we haven't even got in the house. I haven't even talked about the house. A little fun fact about me. I actually have a 66 convertible Mustang. Now, it was my dad's first car. It does not run and drive. He told me if I wanted to fix it up, I could have it. I've seen these online before where there's a company that builds these pool tables. I would die. So, a little bit about this one before I start drooling. This is the Sundance. Two and a half bath, two car garage. It is 2,225 square feet. Now, this one starts at $641,995. Now, just a little bit about this community. It is a age restricted community, 55 and older. You know, you could have your grandkids come over and visit, but they can't, you know, live here permanently. I'm drooling. Also, with this home, it probably has, just knowing this builder, it's a Toll Brothers community over here in Summerlin. It probably has, I don't know, call it 800,000 put into it, maybe more. So do not let this one fool you with this tour. This is nothing in this home is standard. I mean, they put in a full bar right here. What a fun house. Look at this, there's four bars, taps. They have like a whole storage closet right here. You would probably be able to get one car in here. Not two. Well, obviously you can't get one in with, there's already a car in here. But what a fun garage. Again, if you are new, make sure to subscribe. I put videos out every single day. Do me that huge favor, hit the like button because it really, really does help out with the YouTube algorithm. Let's go ahead and start this tour. I was drooling over the garage when I walked by it. But coming on in, by the way, little fact also, HOA here is $308 a month. You're basically in a golf course community without the golf course. So you have the whole clubhouse, you have everything else. Also, if you are new to the channel, you haven't heard me say it before, if you are thinking about buying new, you want to buy new, make sure to call a realtor. Don't go into the sales office. Don't go filling out information online because the sales associates, the builder, will not let you be represented. The sales associates work for the builder. They have their fiduciary responsibility to the builder. Little fun fact, as the buyer, the builder pays the commission. So if you have questions about that, all of my info is down in the description below. How cool is this? This is the fun house. So, obviously, Vegas at its finest. So, you have that whole bar outside. You have this whole bar inside. Look at the stone on this. It is so, so neat. They did the whole, I guess, party inside, party outside. So, there's the bar in the garage, bar right here. Really, really neat. So fun. Once we're allowed to start having people over again, I know Nevada's kind of open. I grew up in California and I know it's like just opened, 2 weeks ago? So we have all of the whiskeys, all of the champagne flutes. Very, very cool. They even have this whole courtyard that has sliders here, sliders there, sliders there. So they really, really did it up. I didn't even notice they have this glass mirror right here. It's really cool. Again, coming in. Very, very neat. Let's go ahead and head on down here. We'll make our way around. So they did a bunch of built-ins right here. This may be more than $800,000. Again, because they've done the backyard. They've done all, like every single option that they have, they put into these models. Right here we have our first bedroom. Now remember, age-restricted community, 55 and older. These are only going to be two-bedroom homes. Full-size bed, two nightstands. They did do the crown molding all the way around. These are 10-foot ceilings, so it makes the room feel a little bit bigger. And then nice big window. I feel like it goes a little low. And then two-door closet slider. Now, again, that's all optioned up. It's going to have the single bar and rod. But, wow. We are just getting inside. And we have an ensuite. Very nice. So it is the lower height countertop, which is kind of surprising, to be honest. Upgraded cabinets, upgraded countertop, upgraded sink. They even did this really cool mirror. The framed mirror. You have your toilet, and then I've noticed they're not doing tubs, at least what I've seen in these homes. They tiled all the way to the ceiling. This is kind of a nice feature. It's not quite zero threshold, but it might as well be zero threshold or curbless. There's just the smallest of small lips right there. I know a lot of people are gonna appreciate that. Just because then you don't have to step over the tub or the lip or anything like that. You don't have to trip and fall, but very, very, very nice. If we continue on, again, all these built-ins, right here is our powder room. Look at all of the molding. They did wallpaper all around, another framed mirror, and then pedestal sink. Whoa, I'm just even realizing even more. They did that glass all the way around. Or excuse me, not glass, but the mirror. We continue on. They did all of these inlays, these mosaics with the hardwood. Again, we have a little side yard. And of course, what do you have? You have a poker table. It's a very, very Vegas house. Kind of cool. So we have the luma wood. It's not actually real wood. It's really nice because it doesn't rot, doesn't fade, or it may fade a little bit, but it lasts way longer than real wood. There's a fireplace over there. Now, looks like they're having a little bit of trouble. There's two water features right there and there. And then they even did a built-in TV. Wow. And then you can even open up that wall too. Before we check out the living, dining, all of that good stuff. Let's come on down here and see. And they did all of these inlays everywhere. So, again, everything's upgraded. Washer, dryer, the countertops, the sink, the lowers, the backsplash, the uppers. A standard one is gonna give you the shelf. I'm gonna try to get in and film a couple of the spec'd homes that have been built by the builder but not purchased yet to try to give you an idea of what this home has in it versus what quote unquote a normal house would, even double stacked Wolf appliances. We'll get in there, but just so you can see, this is kind of a nice feature. You can sneak in right here and around to both the garage and the master bedroom. So again, all of these built-ins, there's even outlets. Like there's outlets here, here, and there's another one right there. They have all the display cabinets. Let me know, is this kind of your style of home? I know a lot of people are liking more of those modern styles. I don't know. I would be, well, the garage alone sells me on it with that really, really cool pool table. We have our linen closet. And we have, again, same cabinets, same countertops. These sinks are cool. They actually have like a bit of a moon shape to them. And then another framed mirror. And then again, what I've noticed, these homes, they're not putting bathtubs in it. I know I'm seeing that more and more when I'm seeing remodeled homes in age-restricted communities that have tubs. They're getting rid of them. But they tiled everything. I do appreciate the fact that the valve's right here so you don't have to go all the way on into the shower when you turn it on, get cold water. This is your toweling off area. And then I do believe you can actually put a rain shower head, but they didn't. You have your bench, you have your standard shower head, no soap niche. But again, very, very nice. They didn't go curbless on this one, which is kind of interesting. They went curbless on the secondary. If we spin around, we get to our toilet area. And I love the fact that they're opening the doors out rather than in, so you don't get trapped in there and have to go up on your tiptoes. So really, really nice features. It's these little subtle touches that make such a big difference. Right here we have our closet. And they're trying to show off everything again. It's kind of cool with all the red paint on it. But it's not a bad size. It's not the biggest one I've seen. But again, there's all these other storage, like nooks and cranny area. You have all the areas for your shoes. You have the hanging areas. You have the areas for like watches and jewelry and even displays. So if you want to put your purses and whatnot or bags. And then even like some little cabinets. More hanging area and more drawers. It's pretty nice. And we haven't even seen the living room. We haven't even seen the master bedroom yet. So, I'm really, really gonna be nitpicky, and it's just me. I'm not the biggest fan of the inlay carpet, but I mean, I'm really, really being nitpicky because this room is amazing. King size bed. They have the nightstands, they have all the cabinets. They even did like the, the tufted back wall. They did this really interesting ceiling, really cool. They put this big slider in the back so you could walk straight out. They even put tile right there as well. We'll go out back here in a minute. One thing to note, if you were buying new, make sure you realize that the backyard is dirt. It is up to you to finish it however you so choose. Average backyard is anywhere between 12 and 15,000. Now there is nothing average about this backyard. They tiled out. You have your jacuzzi. There is a, I don't want to call it a moat, but there's a stream that goes to the pool. And then you even have the pergola out there with the sun lounge. We'll go out back. But again, 12 to 15,000 for the average backyard out here. Now, if you put a pool heater, spa, add 45,000 on top of that because that's how much it's gonna cost. Again, we could sneak in right here, or we can go this way. Again, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe because I put videos out every single day. If you have questions about anything I am saying, please, please, please feel free to reach out to me. Give me a call. Look at this. So again, slider. There's even another slider. Oh no, excuse me, there's not. I bet you could put a slider on that wall as well. But we have our living space. Wow. I'm kind of lost for words. I really, really like the dark crown molding too. They did the fireplace. Those are like $15,000 to $20,000 options, just to let you know, because they're gas. They're very, very expensive. We have our sitting area. And then, wow. Before we check this out though, I'm kind of a loss for words. Let's just check out the outside really quickly. So again, outdoor sitting area. They even did, that's a heater. I can feel them, they have them on. It's actually really nice. We have this whole outdoor barbecue area. They even extended the pergola out and another fireplace, another TV entertaining area. This is so cool. I feel like every house needs this. Your little stream. What a fun house. Lots of just lounging areas. But let's go ahead, head on in and check out that kitchen. So, those uppers, I would need a ladder, and I'm 6 foot, they're up there. Because they're really up there, really pretty to display all the china and everything. We have our dining area. And I feel like you could put a really long, since there's no door here, you could go with a really long table. And then they have the whole server area. They backsplashed that whole wall. Jeez, they even have the pot filler. I'll show you about those here in a minute. Right here we have our island. It's really, really nice. I love the stone choices they're picking. It's almost like crystals in it. But right here we have our microwave. We have an espresso machine. Tons and tons of cabinetry. One thing to note, there is no pantry. But you have all the cabinetry here. You have cabinetry under the island right here. I'll get around to it and show you in here in a second too. We have this really, really nice Sub-Zero fridge, freezer, everything. Double oven. You have your four burners plus your griddle and everything else in it. Right here, if you've never seen one of these before, this is your pot filler. So you pull this out, put it above your pot, you turn on the water, and then you don't have to take the pot back and forth. Let me grab my paper real quick. They do have a phone outlet. You have a huge vent hood. I mean, it's like industrial kitchen. I'm gonna spin real quick just so you can see the rest of the island. There is more cabinetry. Really, really nice apron sink. Here is your view. We have our dishwasher. And again, back around. Let me know what you guys think about this one. These homes up here are pretty incredible. They do have a couple quick move-in homes. I'm gonna go film some of those as well, just so you could see what this model is versus what, you know, on average, people put 15 to 20%, what something like that looks like. Just because this is, I know the base price again is $641, $642. This is nowhere near that price. It's way, way higher. Again, if you have any questions about what you've seen, this tour, any other tour, please, please, please feel free to reach out to me. I'd love to answer any questions, help you out in any way, whether you'd like to see a new home, resale, anything in between. So definitely give me a call. Again, do me that huge favor, hit the like button, make sure to subscribe. And as always, thanks for tagging along with Tour Time with Tyler. Stay safe out there, everyone.